Hi, in this video I will show you how new versions of Tooth&Nail ramp. There are still the same ramping 1 drops as in older versions, some auras, but instead of additional untappers there is Llanowar Tribe. For 3 mana, a 3/3 creature that has tap, add 3 green mana. It's better than any individual untapper, because it doesn't rely on auras, and while Overgrowth ramps you by 2, Llanowar Tribe ramps you by 3. It's also a redundant 3 mana ramp spell. This is important because the new ramp pattern is using 1 drops to ramp into 3 drops. Then there is Nissa's Pilgrimage, also a 3 drop, that's split between main deck and sideboard. It's used against very interactive decks because ramp it provides is immune to removal, unlike Overgrowth or Llanowar Tribe. This spell lets you search your library for up to 2 basic forests, put one onto the battlefield and one into your hand. If you also have primal commands in your deck, you may be able to activate Spell Mastery, allowing you to search your library for up to 3 forests. Old versions of Tooth&Nail that relied heavily on auras were very soft to land destruction. But if you manage to resolve Llanowar Tribe against such a deck and it remains unanswered, you are very likely to win that game, because every other Stone Rain effect will have diminished effect. Then there are other cards that help Tooth&Nail ramping, like Castle Garenbrig. If you have 5 forests, you have 5 mana, but if you have 4 forests and castle, you have 6. So basically, Castle Garenbrig is a land that taps for 2 mana, and cost of playing it in Tooth&Nail is very low. Moving on to Planeswalkers. I believe Nissa Who Shakes the World is the ultimate ramp spell for Tooth&Nail. Let's start with her passive ability. It's similar to that of Heartbeat of Spring, but Heartbeat of Spring is symmetrical and works for all lands, so you have double mana and your opponent have double mana. Then there is Vernal Bloom, that is also symmetrical but only doubles mana from forests. And lastly, for one more mana, there is Nissa, that doubles mana from forests but only for you. And for that one additional mana, you also have a Planeswalker with abilities. If you compare this Nissa to the one used in older Tooth&Nail versions, the World Waker, you will see, maybe you will see, that the newer Nissa is far superior. Let's compare how they ramp. The newer one passively doubles your mana without using any loyalty abilities, while Nissa World Waker has to use her other plus one ability to ramp you. So the old one can either ramp you or animate lands, while the new one can do both. Next, what happens if you cast either of them and tap out? Nissa Who Shakes the World will untap a land and turn it into a 3/3 creature that can block and even attack the same turn. She will also be at 6 loyalty. She can protect herself. While if you tap out for Nissa World Waker, you will turn one of your tapped lands into a 4/4 creature. She will only have 4 loyalty. As you can see, Nissa Who Shakes the World is a stronger card. This new ramp pattern allows you to cast Panglacial Worm on turn 3, which is a very important card in Tooth and Nail recently. For 7 mana, it's a 9/5 creature with trample that you can cast while you are searching your library. So for example, if you crack a fetch land. And you can do it as soon as turn 3, and I'll show you two ways how you can do it. For example, you can cast Arbor Elf on turn 1, then on turn 2, Overgrowth, and on turn 3, play a fetch land and pass. On your opponent's turn, you can cast Panglacial Worm either to surprise block their creature or just anti-end step to make them use their counter spells or anything like that. So you make 3 mana with enchanted lands, 6, 7, crack your fetch land, pay 7 mana for Panglacial Worm, and get your forests with Wooden Foothills. Another way you can cast Panglacial Worm on turn 3 is with Llanowar Tribe and Castle Garenbrig. So, turn 1, Birds or Arbor Elf or Utopia Sprawl, anything really. Then on turn 2, Castle Garenbrig into Llanowar Tribe. On turn 3, play a fetch land and pass. On your opponent's turn, you will tap Llanowar Tribe and Forest for 4 mana, make 6 with Castle, and then 7 with Birds. You will crack your fetch land, cast Worm, and get your Forest. Those are the two ways you can get Panglacial Worm on turn 3. But it doesn't have to be on turn 3. Panglacial Worm is there to give you something to cast even if you don't have relevant spells in hand. And I will talk more about it later. One last thing I wanted to mention is that instead of Birds of Paradise, you can play Gilded Goose. There are a few reasons for it. Birds of Paradise is good at giving you mana for tempo plays. So if you can spend this additional mana every turn, then you are getting the most out of it. But a ramp deck is not a tempo deck. It will often have some mana left over. And you can use this mana to create food tokens. And then you can crack those food tokens to gain you some life. This way you can sometimes prolong the game long enough so that you will be able to survive longer and maybe draw into your game-winning spells. Gilded Goose also doesn't die to Renan 6 and Plague Engineer. It's also more resilient to Walking Ballista and Lava Dart. And that's all I have to say about how new versions of Tooth and Nail ramp.